As we've seen, no part of the world has been spared from the effects of the coronavirus. People in nearly every country have been infected and fallen seriously ill. And as William Brangham reports, sometimes even those who know viruses most intimately fall victim.
Dr. Peter Piot has been chasing viruses his entire career. He was among the team that first discovered Ebola. Later, he helped prove it was HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, that was killing people in Africa. For two decades, he led two of the biggest global efforts to fight HIV/AIDS. But this March, the 71-year-old Piot got coronavirus. He's not sure how he was infected, but he had a terrible, painful stretch fighting COVID-19. I spoke with him recently from his home in London, England. Peter Piot, welcome back to the NewsHour. Very good to see you.
To see you.
Can you just tell us a little bit about your experience suffering with COVID-19?
Well, after spending most of my adult life fighting viruses, from Ebola to particularly HIV, a virus got me. And on the 19th of March, I came down really pretty within a few hours with very severe headache, splitting headache, high fever, myalgias, my muscles, everything ached, and I got really, really exhausted. And for 7 days, I was in the hospital with oxygen. And until it was at the level that I could go back home, and things continued to improve. I had also bacterial pneumonia. I was treated for that, but I was still completely knocked out. You know, it's really when as if you're hit by a truck or so or a bus. And then suddenly I started experiencing shortness of breath. I went to the hospital again, and they diagnosed this with a post-COVID, with a, a pneumonia that's the result of, not of the virus directly, but of the inflammatory reaction. One of the things I didn't know was that it can be so chronic, that people have kidney problems, people have chronic lung problems, cardiac problems.
Things that will last for the rest of your life.
Yeah, it could be, yes. And so we need to plan for that as well. While, of course, we're trying to do everything to stop this virus from spreading.
I'm curious that as someone, as you were describing, who has fought against viruses your entire career and studied how they mutate, how they replicate, how they transmit from person to person, was there a point in your own illness where you moved from being you, the scientist, to you, the patient?
Yes. The moment I went to the emergency room and I saw my chest x-ray where clearly pneumonia, bacterial pneumonia, my oxygen saturation and so on, I switched from the doctor, from the scientist, the doctor, to the patient. You know, your world, shrinks completely. You know, you think of breathing. Will I get out of here? How will I get out of here? I don't want to get on a ventilator. I was thinking of my wife, my children, and yeah, it was a really, really different experience for me.
You said earlier that the virus got you, and I know in another interview you described this as the virus getting revenge for all of the labors you've done to push back on viruses all over the world. Do you see it? I mean, I understand that's a metaphor, but do you see it that way? Do you see that a virus finally caught up with you?
Yes and no. I mean, maybe I thought they couldn't get me. I was, I was kind of invincible. Normally you feel like that when you're 27, but I always try to say, even in the saddest moments, to find a bit of humor and satire and, enjoy, like the fact I lost 7 kilos. And I said, that's a silver lining, because with all my exercise, I never got my BMI to within normal range, and now I'm there. So, okay.
The COVID diet plan.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's going to take off.
I'm not suggesting it, but although I was careful, already before we had a lockdown and start working remotely, I wouldn't shake hands. I would keep some distance, but obviously it was not enough.
In much of your career at UNAIDS, you talked a lot about and wrestled a lot with balancing the competing interests sometimes of science and politics and economics. And yeah. We've certainly seen that being a struggle here with public health officials urging lockdowns and the economic and political pressure to say, no, you're strangling our economy. We have to reopen. Do you think that we have struck the right balance thus far in this pandemic?
It's the reality of life, of everything, this trade-off. And it's come to very extreme dimensions with COVID-19, because we know that the virus is still there. And if we relax public health measures, we will nearly guaranteed have a second wave and a third wave and outbreaks. So we need to approach it, I think, as a risk management, because we can't close society forever, because we'll all get so poor and there will be nothing to fight the epidemic with. On the other hand, if this epidemic is not under control, we simply can't restart the economy at full speed. So as societies, we'll have to learn how to live with COVID-19 and with a certain risk that we accept or not. I mean, it's not as extreme as, we accept that X people a year die in car accidents. We're not going to stop driving a car. However, the problem with the COVID-19 is that if we don't bring it really under control and make, for example, hospitals, healthcare settings safe, that's going to undermine a lot of other things. So we need to put our efforts there where the epidemic is.
All right, Peter Piot, very nice to see you upright and healthy again. Thank you very, very much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.